This is an original movie poster from 1973 for the film The Mack. The poster was in A-plus condition, and the owner wanted it preserved that way. Hi, I'm Chris Cloutier, and welcome to Poster Fix Studio. Today, a short video showing how we flattened out this poster and got rid of the creases so that the owner could hang this poster proudly in his home. Poster Fix is an archival mounting process. It is linen backing. And linen backing is a way to preserve and flatten out your poster, especially good for vintage posters, when you want them to last longer and stay stronger. So let's watch the process of linen backing the Mack. The process starts by cleaning off a stretcher screen. I have to pull off all the old canvas and staples from the previous job. This poster that we're going to linen back is in much better condition than most of the posters that I get to linen back. The principal reason for him to have me linen back this is to neutralize the acids in the paper so that it won't age as noticeably over time, as well as giving it a strong backing for framing. Now I've got the canvas stretched, and it's time to apply the wheat paste to the paper. We put wheat paste on acid-free paper and then mount the acid-free paper to the cotton canvas before mounting the poster. For those of you who watch my videos who are interested in seeing movie posters with all African-American cast members in the roles, we linen backed a poster for a movie called The Green-Eyed Monster, which refers to a train. It was a silent film made by an African-American-owned film company in Florida in 1920 and had an all-black cast. The movie is lost now, but the poster survived, and I suggest you check out the video to learn more about it. From that period of the 1920s to the 1970s, there have not been that many films made with all-black casts, with the possible exception of Stormy Weather. But in the 1970s, this genre took off, often referred to as black exploitation or blaxploitation films. I'm using a roller to push out all the excess air pockets and excess wheat paste. The poster is printed on cardstock. It's one of those weird format wide posters that are always printed on cardstock and never folded. When they are folded, it ruins them because they don't flatten well. But this one has no folio folds. We're spraying the poster with water so that it flattens out. And we're using a special mixture of wheat paste, a cocktail with other glues, that I use specifically for glossy posters. This mixture
is a trade secret.
The Mack is a 1973 film directed by California native Michael Campus, starring Max Julien and Richard Pryor. The film also stars Oscar nominee Juanita Moore and Tony-nominated actor Dick Anthony Williams. Filmed in Oakland, California, the movie follows the rise and fall of Goldie. After returning home from prison after 5 years, he finds his brother involved in black nationalism. Goldie decides to take an alternative path, striving to become the city's biggest pimp. Though reviews were less than favorable upon initial release, The Mack is considered by many critics to be the best film of its genre, the genre being called blaxploitation. But Michael Campus, Max Julien, and others involved in its production have argued that that genre label often oversimplifies the film. And I agree.
This poster has a glossy surface, semi-gloss, and probably is sensitive.
The film soundtrack was recorded by Motown artist Willie Hutch. Before rolling out the poster with the roller, we're going over it with a sponge, because I believe the face of the poster is probably very sensitive. The inks might scratch if I apply too much pressure to it.
The Mack is backed. We are going to let this screen dry for a few days before we cut it down.
This is Chris. After 32 years of restoring vintage posters, I still look forward to seeing what you're going to send me to restore. So don't hesitate to call me or email me if you have any questions about your posters. Thank you very much. While I wait for the Mack screen to dry, I'm going to take two posters out of frames that someone gave me to Lindenback, actually the same owner as with this poster. These posters, one for Do the Right Thing and the other for Scarface, are in cheap frames with plexiglass, and they're mounted to board. I have no idea how they're mounted, and I can't test them to see whether or not they will come off the board until I take them out of the frame, discard the frame. Once out of the frame, I'm going to test it with naphtha to see whether or not they come off the board.
Thank you.
I've tested these with naphtha and I cannot get them off the board. I've got to think about it for a while to see what I might try next. Most other solvents are too strong. They would cause the inks to run, so I'm not sure if I should do anything with these posters or not. Perhaps I should do the right thing and not do anything at all. Let's get back to the Mack. As you can see, the Mack has been preserved and flattened through the process at PosterFix. And this brings us to the end of another segment of PosterFix for today. After 33 years of restoring vintage posters, I look forward still to seeing what unusual things you're going to send me. So stay safe, smart, and healthy, and see you next time.